The views expressed in the following program are those of the participants and do not necessarily reflect the views of Saga 960 AM or its management.
Live from Toronto to the world.
Josh!
This is Josh Holiday Live. Talk that rocks.
The public needs to be informed.
Josh might surprise us.
Got an opinion? Dial 647-6-YO-JOSH.
When you hear him, you're like, what?
Josh Holiday Live starts now.
Hello. Good day to our Australian listeners. I believe that's how they like to be greeted. Good day. Maybe with more of an accent.
Good day. Good day, mate.
I say hello to all. One and all. It is Josh Holiday Live, and it's in fact true. We are live. It's been too long. Couple of weeks. Last week, woke up, ready to go live, all set, getting up and waking up, having breakfast, thinking, okay, let's figure out what we're going to do on the show today. Then trying to go and pick out interesting stories and news items and realizing that no, there was no internet, no cellular service, and I am a Rogers customer, so I was S out of luck, as it were, last Friday. So we ended up running a recycled show, a rerun, if you will. At least we were ecologically doing the right thing in recycling. So we should get some points for that, right? You can call us anytime during this hour, and I will pick up the phone. The number is 6476-YO-JOSH, or if you prefer just the numbers, it's 647-696-5674. Busy show. We're going to tell you a little bit later on the show, what's the best sex position? Scientifically, what is the best sex position? We're going to pay tribute to a Canadian comedian who left this mortal coil way too soon. We are going to figure out if we are sometimes being accidentally rude. We'll have some things that maybe indications that you're being accidentally rude. And then we'll take a look at this obituary that is one of the most savage obituaries I've ever read. It's really a takedown. So much so that the newspaper that published it had to issue an apology. I guess the editor of the obit section didn't really look too closely at the content of this obit. We will share the content with you, talk about some of the crazy foods they had at Calgary Stampede and they may have at the Toronto exhibition. So all sorts of stuff coming up. It is a world in chaos, and we are here to try and entertain. The seventh wave is upon us. Get your dosage, please. Get vaxxed if you haven't had one. Get one if you've had two. Get three if you had three, and you're eligible. Get four. I have to wait till August 7th because I had the COVID about 2 months ago or two and change. You have to wait three months after you've had your first negative test after having had COVID. The U.S. is crumbling before our very eyes. All sorts of insanity south of the border. The whole abortion thing. These old men want to take away women's rights to do what they will with their body. It's like a Handmaid's Tale come to life. Mass shootings and little will to get gun control measures in place to try and cut down on the amount of children who are dying in mass shootings, not just children, everybody, all kinds of people dying as a result of mass shootings and usually with assault-style weapons. And then the whole January 6th committee, the more that comes out about that, the more it shines a light on how close the U.S. was to losing democracy, to no longer being a democratic country. As it is, it's slowly slipping towards being undemocratic with the Republicans trying to clamp down on voting rights, trying to turn back the clock on voting rights, and loading the Supreme Court with political activists. It's not looking good. I think the only thing that could save the country is more Democratic senators in November. If not, it's game over for the U.S. as a democracy. But let's not focus on the politics stuff. I've made the pledge to you and to myself that I wouldn't focus as much on political stuff, medical stuff. I want to focus on just fun stuff as much as possible, entertaining stuff. And I do want your calls. If you want to chat about stuff, I'm more than welcome to take your calls, or you're more than welcome to call, I should say. I am a Leafs fan. I have the sickness. I follow them through all of the ups and downs, and lately it's been downs. Every year they get knocked out in the first round of the playoffs, and it seems like so far every year they're like, let's just run it back with a few minor tweaks and hope for the best. And the Leafs at the trade deadline underwhelmed in a large way. They picked up a goaltender who was a really good goaltender 5 years ago, has a history of injuries. In the last 2 years he's played, he's been subpar. They are hoping that he turns that around. And it seems like a not a great bet for a team that wants to do things in the postseason. They have a bit of a backup plan and a backup goalie in a gentleman named Samsonov. That's his last name. He is a young goalie, 25 years old, played for Washington. A bit streaky, but there is some potential upside there. But still, if you're looking to have no question marks in the crease, you didn't do a good job at this trade deadline. And so far, the other additions are mostly around the edges, fringe players. I do like the fact that the players we did get are willing to, they have a high compete level. They're willing to hit, willing to agitate. We have, as I've mentioned before, we have too many nice guys on this Leafs team, not enough a-holes. And so we want to up the a-hole quotient, and at least we're doing that. But as far as the free agent frenzy happened, Kyle Dubas, so far not looking great. So he has said that he's going to make more changes, and that makes sense because they signed even more kind of fringe players recently. So it feels like they have to make some sort of change, and we will wait and see to pass judgment, but it still feels like they need a major trade before the season begins, and we will see what happens. I'm a documentary lover, and I will recommend two newish documentaries to you. There's one on Netflix called The Girl in the Picture. It's a true crime story, and I don't want to give too much of the plot away, but there's a lot of twists and turns, and it's, in the end, it's tremendously sad, but it's just an amazing story, and not necessarily a great ending and not happy things, but it's a really fascinating true crime story. Another documentary series that I just started the first episode of, I think there might be six, It's How to Change Your Mind. And it is about the use of psychedelic medicine. The first episode focused on LSD, which in like the 50s, there were studies, 50s and early 60s, there were studies, and it was showing a lot of progress for helping people with mental health disorders. But then it kind of got out into the wild, and you know, the hippies were taking the acid and the general public were taking the acid, and Nixon decided to focus on why that's bad, people taking acid, and so they made that drug basically a felony to have, and all of the studies kind of closed up, and for many, many years that was the case until maybe 20 years ago, where they started researching again, and not just LSD, magic mushrooms, and basically they're finding more and more with a lot of these studies that these are helpful for a number of mental health issues, PTSD, pain in some cases. And I'm a believer. I've never done acid. I've had friends who've done it, did it in high school. I like mushrooms. About once a year, I will try magic mushrooms, and I do find that, like, I've had depression issues and mental health issues in the past, and I've found that it really puts me back on track. I find it very, very therapeutic. I'm not suggesting that you do it without the advice or consent of a doctor, but I did find it helpful. The Stampede in Calgary has come and gone. I lived there for 2 years, not so long ago, hosted an afternoon radio show at a alternative rock station there. And the Calgary Stampede, if you've not been, is basically the Canadian National Exhibition, the CNE, the X, with horses. It's basically, you know, all the trash and rides and all that junk of the X that we have here the last couple of weeks of August. But they have rodeo stuff happening as well in the stadium area. And some of the foods that debuted this year, these X's and these Stampedes tend to highlight new food trends to try to attract media attention and bring people to the fair. Here are some of the things that were featured at the Calgary Stampede this year. Pop Rocks Popcorn Chicken. So it's the candy you enjoyed as a kid, add it to chicken. Taste the explosion. Sounds kind of weird, but it might be good. I don't know. I haven't tried it. Maybe it'll be at the X. This one is one that I would not be a fan of. Crazy Tongue Pizza. So this is tomato sauce, mozzarella, slow-braised AAA Alberta cow tongue, natural pineapple, caramelized onions, and a Baja Chipotle drizzle. You lost me at cow tongue. No, thank you. Cajun fried poutine. Golden curds, lightly breaded and fried, then placed on a bed of hot Cajun curly fries, all under a blanket of fresh gravy. I'm not a spice guy, but I imagine the gravy would help cool things down. Sounds healthy, though. The deep fryer. Every year there's a new deep fried trend. I remember deep fried butter was a big one recently. Deep fried Coca-Cola, deep fried candy bars. So the deep fryer seems to be a staple of these things every year. What are we going to deep fry this year? Is it a shoe that's edible? I don't know. In this case, it's deep fried Oreo mini donuts. So you have Oreo cookies, deep fried inside those mini donuts topped with powdered sugar and chocolate sauce. I don't know. The Oreo is a cookie. I think it's overrated. It's not really a great, like any of those, like, I guess I've been spoiled by you know, more homemade and bakery made cookies, but the Oreo, I don't know. I'm not a huge Oreo guy, but those mini donuts, damn, those are good. There's a place going off on a tangent here, but there's a place down, just north of Queen Street, east of the DVP. I was doing a film thing down there, and there's a donut place that makes these amazing mini donuts. And the name of it is escaping me, but oh my God, they're so delicious. Kind of like the donuts you would get at the CNE, like the mini, the Toms, or the mini donuts. They did have the cinnamon sugar ones, which I love, but they also had more specialty ones, like ones coated in red velvet cakey type stuff. Those kind of fancy donuts, but quite delicious. Another food that was featured at the Calgary Stampede this year was Flamin' Cheetos fries. So these are fresh cut French fries taken to the next level by adding jalapeno cheese sauce topped off with crunchy Flamin' Cheetos. Maybe. Again, I'm not super into the spicy stuff, but sounds good. Cheese sauce. Can't go wrong with cheese sauce. Korean squid ink corn dog. Half mozzarella, half hot dog, dipped in a black batter with one end cut to resemble tentacles. I don't know about that. First of all, hot dogs. I'm not a fan of hot dogs. I think as soon as you kind of learn how hot dogs are made, it's hard to for me anyway, to eat a hot dog now, knowing that it's a-holes and eyeballs, basically. And finally, another new food that was featured at the Calgary Stampede, Bad Breath Lemonade. Now, this is ice-cold lemonade with a smooth, delicious garlic and caramelized onion finish. I don't know about that. Although I will say this. People like garlic in their food. I'm a huge garlic lover. And I used to go to a restaurant in Calgary called the Garlic Clove. And every meal they served featured garlic. And it was damn delicious. I went there for a birthday once, and they had a dessert that was vanilla ice cream, caramelized bananas with garlic. And I was really, really surprised that the sweet went with garlic so well. I was amazed. It was really, really good. Very delicious. We will wait and see what the X has to offer when it comes back for real this summer, later in August and the first part of September. I can't wait. I can't wait to see. I don't know how many of the things I'll sample because I have so many food peccadillos. We'll wait and see. We are going to go over one of the most savage obituaries I've ever read and find out if you're being accidentally rude in just a bit.
KPA Lawyers is one of Peel Region's most popularly rated law firms on Google, and we assist clients in a wide variety of legal services. Whether you're looking for a real estate lawyer to close your housing transaction, or need a compassionate family lawyer who can help you get through a separation or divorce, KPA will have the right lawyer for you. KPA is not like some other law firms that just refer your case to another company. All of our legal services are performed in-house by our team of experienced and knowledgeable lawyers. Learn more and book an appointment online by visiting us at kpalawyers.ca. You can also call 905-965-6263 between 9 a.m. and 5 p.m. Monday to Friday. Once again, our website is kpalawyers.ca and our phone number is 905-965-6263.
Hello, I am Greg Carrasco and I have changed.
It is time for Greg Carrasco!
Kick it! Whoa, it's the Greg Carrasco show. Get this party on the road. How fast can this right go? Whoa!
Change stations, that is. Join me at the new home of the Greg Carrasco Show on Saga 960 AM. Politics, cars, God, and everything in between. You tell me what you want to talk about, and we will do it. There's no need to be afraid. Every Saturday morning, 8 to 11 AM, only at the Greg Carrasco Show on Saga 960 AM. You weren't planning on sleeping in, were you?
Most people don't plan to fail. They fail to plan. Ask Jeff, the go-to guy. Help you plan for today and protect for tomorrow. As a 5-star award winner with Wealth Professional, Jeff has helped people just like you achieve their financial goals and support their future with his unique 360-degree process. With his team of professionals, he can help you and your finances work smarter, not harder, in protecting your hard-earned money. Whether it is life insurance, living benefits, group insurance, investments, or financial planning, Jeff is the go-to guy, and he is here to help plan for your future. All you got to do is go to askjeff.ca, the go-to guy. That's askgeoff.ca. That's askjeff.ca. And join Jeff every Monday on Monday Wealth on the Mark Petroni Show at 2:45 p.m. on Saga 960 AM.
Stream us live at saga960am.ca.
Josh Holiday Live is in your ear. You got something to say? Call 647-6-YO-JOSH now.
Those who have been following Josh, Josh is available
on Twitter at Josh Holiday and visit joshholidaylive.com.
Oh, there it is. Took a while for that music to start. You're no good. Little East Coast Canadian rock. Sons of Freedom. It is Josh Holiday here, and I played that song, You're No Good, because, and this is where the radio magic happens, I play a song that has a title that somehow refers to what I'm about to talk to. I know for you radio students out there that that's a good lesson. If you're doing radio and you want to talk about a topic, and you're doing talk radio, which probably won't be around for much longer in its current form, you play a song that somehow hints at the thing you're about to talk about. Now, here's where an error was made. Usually, you don't name the connection, as I did. You just let the audience figure it out. It's like putting a little puzzle in there, adding a layer to the show. If they don't figure it out, that's fine. If they do, even better. This is a Savage obituary written by an unhappy son. It was in a newspaper, and I guess it slipped through the newspaper editorial people. The obituary section editors, and they had to apologize. Well, they didn't have to, but they felt they needed to apologize. And the obituary is not on their site, but it's still on the funeral home site. And I thought we would read it to you. We would highlight this obituary from a unhappy son. Lawrence H. Pfaff Sr. was born in Belmont, New York on April 16th, 1941. He passed away on June 27th, 2022, living a long life, much longer than he deserved. He is survived by his three children. No, four. Oops, five children. Well, as of 2022, we believe there is one more that we know about, but there could be more. His love was abundant when it came to himself, but for his children, it was limited. From a young age, he was a ladies' man and an abusive alcoholic, solidifying his commitment to both with a path of destruction he left behind, damaging his adult children and leaving them broken. The obituary continues. Lawrence Sr.'s hobbies included abusing his first wife and children. He loved to start projects, but never followed through on any of them. He enjoyed the life of a barfly for many years and had a quaint little living space, studio, above his favorite hole in the wall, the Club Nashville. Lawrence Sr. did spend over 20 years in the NYPD, but even his time in service was negligent at best. Because of his alcohol addiction, his commanding officer took away his gun and badge, replacing them with a broom until he could get his act together. Lawrence Sr. did claim to be clean and sober for over 30 years, but never worked any of the 12 steps, including the 8th and 9th steps with his children, making amends. He possesses no redeeming qualities for his children, including the ones he knew and the, quote, ones he knew about. It will be challenging to miss Lawrence Sr. because he was narcissistic. He was incapable of love. Lawrence Sr.'s passing proves that evil does eventually die, and it marks a time of healing, which will allow his children to get the closure they deserve. Lawrence Sr. can be remembered for being a father to many and a dad to none. Savage. Savage obituary. Oh, boy. I think the son might need some therapy. There's a lot of anger there. Quite a bit of anger. I wrote my father's obituary, and though I had many issues with him, I wrote a nice obituary. An obituary that didn't spit on a grave, as it were. So that was probably the most savage obituary I've ever seen anyway. Are you being accidentally rude? This is a list of some of the things that you maybe do but don't realize that you're being rude. And I'm certainly guilty of these. Complimenting someone's new look. Reacting to a person's drastic change in their appearance, such as weight loss, is a delicate business. Saying something like, I can't believe how great you look, implies the person didn't look good before. And I think the other thing with complimenting someone on how they've changed, oh boy, you've lost a lot of weight, you look great. Occasionally, that weight loss isn't on purpose. It could be due to a disease. I know I lost 25 pounds in a couple of months once when I was went into a pretty severe depression and couldn't eat. So it's kind of like, oh, wow, you look great. You lost a lot of weight. And I'm like, yeah, it's the depression diet. Asking, how's it going at a funeral? At a funeral, you need to remember to take the cheerfulness down a notch. Although funerals are tough because everyone reacts to death differently. And I think, it's more in a lot of cases. I think it's nice to have as a celebration of life. If it was a tragic accident and it was someone who passed before their time, and it's a more sort of serene and sober affair. But if it's someone who's lived a long life, an older person who kind of has reached the end, I think it can be treated as more of a celebration of life. And I certainly know when I die, and I'm recording this now, so if you're listening, this is the instruction. I don't want people, you know, sobbing and crying and being sad. Just have some fun and enjoy yourself. Enjoy the sandwiches, the finger sandwiches. I was weird. Like, I talked about my dad and writing his obituary earlier. When his funeral came around, like the reception and then the actual event itself, I didn't cry at all in the first, like, probably until about 3 weeks after he died. And at the funeral, when I would meet people, they say, "Oh, I'm so sorry. I felt like, no, it's okay. I was really, I think I'm maybe a bit of shock, and I just sort of hadn't processed the emotion. So it was almost like they were really sad. And I was like, no, that's okay. Other things that you may, other ways you may be accidentally being rude. Offering unsolicited advice. A friend confides in you. Sometimes it's best just to listen. Sometimes your good intentions and giving your opinion without being asked can rub people the wrong way. This is a dating one. At the end of a date, saying to someone, "Oh, I'll call you," is maybe you think you're being polite, but it's best not to say it if you don't mean it. And probably if you bring out the honesty, saying, "Oh, I had a nice time, but I didn't feel sparks," or whatever the case may be. Don't leave people hanging. Here's another one that there's a famous episode of Seinfeld about. Congratulating a stranger on their pregnancy. Never assume a woman is pregnant. Don't ask how far along are you, or do you know if it's a boy or a girl. Could be they like beer and they have a beer belly and you're insulting them. And this is true also of offering someone a seat on the bus. Sometimes it's, you know, if you see an older person or whatever, it's a judgment call for sure. But if someone certainly has mobility issues, I always get up. I used to get up for women, but now it almost feels like it would be an insult to them. With, you know, it's all about equality. It's like, oh, well, I'm the man. I'll get up so you can sit down. So it's always kind of a awkward decision. And this is the one that I remember is seeing a lady who may or may not have been pregnant, and then trying to figure out, okay, do I get up and offer the seat? I think the safe thing to do is pretend your stop is coming soon and get up and just kind of go stand by the door as if you're getting off. That's sort of a way to avoid that awkwardness. Asking someone why they're still single. Now, I don't understand how a good-looking girl or guy like you can be single. As a single man of a certain age, I've heard that many, 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 many times. I'm always like, well, I'm picky. That's why. And other people are picky, and that's also why. And finally, not correcting someone who gets your name wrong. Out of politeness, you let it slide, and then you can't really go back because after they've called you like John like 5 or 6 times, you can't really say, well, you know, over the last couple of days, you've been calling me John. It's actually Josh. Better to get it out of the way right as the first time they call you by the wrong name. I'm terrible at remembering names. And there's also an expiry date on that as well. Like with this one, if someone uses your wrong name for a while, you can't really go and say, well, actually, you've been saying it wrong for a while. The other one that I find tricky is in the moment when I'm meeting someone, I don't really process their name and put it in my long-term storage. I'm just sort of in the moment, and then I'll forget people's name and I'll see them all over the place and I'll be like, "Hi, oh, how's it going? Hey, friend." And it gets to a point where you know someone so well that it's really, really embarrassing to ask them their name because it feels like you've already developed a rapport with that people. So yeah, such is life. Such is life. It is Josh Holiday Live. You can call us if you want to comment on anything you hear on the show. Good, bad, ugly. You want to talk about it? You hear a story and you're like, oh my God, I have a story like that too. Or, oh my God, this is that. 6476-YO-JOSH is our telephone number. 647-696-5674. Traveling is back. People are traveling more and more now, and there's a survey that came out about traveling. Apparently, 45% of people think travelers are less self-aware and ruder than they were before 2020. That makes sense. You've seen all kinds of YouTube videos of angry flyers, usually anti-mask nutbags. Here's one that was surprising. 94% of people think it's acceptable to bring smelly food onto an airplane. That's crazy. That's we talk a lot on this show about selfishness and how selfishness in general is the cause of many of society's problems. And it's just selfish to bring something stinky onto an airplane. You're going to be in close quarters with other people with not great ventilation because you're packed right next to them. I even, on a car trip, I got mad at my mother because she packed egg salad sandwiches for a car trip in a small, you know, we're just in a small car, windows closed. It was winter. She brought these stinky egg salad, like fart sandwiches, basically. If you say to someone, oh my God, that's a really bad fart, that's like an egg fart, you're basically referring to the smell of egg salad sandwiches. So why would you bring an egg salad sandwich into anywhere enclosed? Or better yet, why would you eat an egg salad sandwich to begin with? You're eating what? I don't know. I can't separate the smell from the taste. So if I smell something that smells like a fart, I can't put it in my mouth. There's no way. 9 in 10 people say it's not good to take your shoes and socks off while flying. Although I did that on a flight this winter. I wore these big, heavy winter boots because I was going to Calgary and it was going to be like freezing cold. And I started getting a sore foot from these things. So I took it off. But generally, I leave the shoes on. And taking your socks off, oh my God, not good. 2 in 3 people think it's okay to start a conversation with someone sitting next to them on a plane. Only 35% say it's an annoying habit. I'm pretty quiet when it comes to being next to people on the plane. Like I think partly because I'm shy. But I've been on flights where I'm on a flight with my mother to Florida, like a 3-hour flight. And sometimes we're in different rows because I'm a very tall fellow and I usually try and get an exit row. And she was on the flight and I was only like 2 rows in front of her, but I could hear her talking to the person beside her for almost the whole flight. And essentially doing like an audible version of her life story. It was like the person next to her knew every last detail, even like, well, you know, it was very costly, cost about this much for this. And oh, when we moved here, my husband, blah, 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 blah. That's too much. I think you can be like courteous and say, hey, how's it going? Or if, you know, just the basics. And if someone wants to have a further conversation, you know, that's fine. When it comes to reclining airline seats, and this is a big point of controversy in flying, most Americans still think of their neighbors first before spreading out. Just 38% think it's okay to recline their seat on a long flight of more than 4 hours. More than half the poll, about 52%, believe it's okay as long as they ask the person behind them first. I will put the seat back, but I'll do it very slowly and not all the way back. So yeah, that's the flight thing. We are going to tell you what the best sex position is scientifically. They did a study. Scientists aren't just finding cures for cancer. They're finding out what sex positions are scientifically best. And we're also going to pay tribute to a young Canadian comedian who passed way before his time. A really pretty brilliant comedian who had so much potential, but it ended way too soon. We'll talk about that in just a bit.
Hi, this is Greg Carrasco from Oakville Nissan. And if you have a car in your life, and by that I mean a car, an SUV, a sports car, a pickup truck, and you want to sell it, but you don't want the hassle of doing it privately, I have a solution for you. Bring it to me. I will make you an offer. And if I end up buying the vehicle from you, we will give you a $1,000 gas card. Come and see me. There's something happening here at OakvilleNissan.com.
I'm Jeff Woods, and I'm shining a light on music and the rock stars who make it.
He just was one of those people. He stood out.
He was a magic guy. He really was a magic guy. We all have force. He had the same amount of force as we all have.
This was before Led Zeppelin. Robert was full on. I mean, he was Led Zeppelin without the band behind him. He had the hair, the jeans, the whole thing, you know. And he was amazing.
The Records and Rockstars podcast, heard around the world and yours to hear wherever you get podcasts. All the episodes from JeffWoodsRadio.com.
Gavia HomeoCare has been a trusted provider of homeopathic care for over 20 years. Any age group, from children to old aged, and from new diseases to the old ones, like allergy, asthma, hair loss, skin disorders, headache and migraine, male and female health issues, digestive disorders and piles, mental health issues, heart problems, or for any acute or chronic diseases. Call 647-760-2779 or visit GaviaHomeoCare.com for more information. Gavia HomeoCare, healthy lifestyle starts here.
Imagine having over 100 TV multi-language channels at your fingertips. Imagine having over 100 multi-language radio stations at your fingertips. Now, imagine an app that lets you watch or listen to all of this amazing entertainment whenever or wherever you want. Now, imagine it's all free. Ibaba is the reality in mobile entertainment. Download Ibaba for iOS or Android. Turn imagination into reality at Ibaba.
No radio? No problem. Stream us live on saga960am.ca.
Talk that rocks. It's Josh Holiday Live. Need to be heard? Tell your phone to call 647-6-YO-JOSH.
It is Josh Holiday Live on the home stretch here. It's 4 o'clock. About a month ago, I was watching a Canadian television show on the Comedy Network called Roast Battle Canada. I'm a fan of comedy roasts. I enjoy them. I like insult comedy. I find it entertaining. And it's a franchise. It was I believe a US program first, where a lot of American comedians would compete to see who the best roaster is. And it's been franchised to England and Canada. And I was watching the Canadian one, and there was a comedian who I wasn't very familiar with on there, by the name of Nick Nemeroff. Now, it's weird, because for a long time, for most of my teens and 20s and early 30s, I was very keyed into the comedy scene. I would do stand up. I was doing comedy reporting on radio, and I was really keyed into it. But over the last few years, I've sort of not been as key contact. I haven't really been performing too much either, which I think is part of it. You're not really around that scene. So this was the first time I think I'd really seen Nick Nemeroff perform, and I was like, wow, this guy is good. Why was I not aware of him? And that's what stuck with me from that show. I was really struck by, like, oh, he's a charismatic, funny guy. Why wasn't he on my radar, and why is he not more successful? Well, not that long after, a couple of weeks after I saw that and saw him, there was a big news story around the comedy in Toronto and Canadian entertainment community that he had passed away, I believe at the age of 32. And I was kind of shocked, because I just discovered this person, and then a couple of weeks later, that's it. So I went back and I checked out some comedy, and very talented guy. He did actually get on Conan, was born in Montreal, but spent a lot of time in Toronto as well. They didn't really give a cause of death. They left it open, so I'm not gonna speculate. But he was 32, so make of that what you will. And I thought, as a tribute, we would play his comedy set from Conan to give you an idea of what that sounded like.
What's up, guys? Like Conan said, my name is Nick Nemiroff, and like most people my age, I am 28. Thank you. Thank you so, so much. I really needed some laughter right now. I just flew in, and I actually got some pretty devastating news from the hospital. I found out that my dad has been pronounced dead, and you know, it just sort of made me think he spent his whole life working and raising me and my brother and my baby sister, and you know, I just can't believe that we've been pronouncing it wrong this whole time. Thank you so much. Thank you so, so much. I needed that laughter, because the truth is I actually got some pretty devastating news from a different hospital. I found out this might be my last stand-up set for a while, because I have to get brain surgery. It's just cosmetic. I feel pretty self-conscious about all the wrinkles. So I'm just going to have them remove the part of my brain that feels that way. I'm just realizing right now I actually forgot my opening joke. Okay. This is a good one. Hey everybody, how's it going? My name's Nick Nemiroff. It's great to be here. Thank you guys for coming out on Tuesday night. Give yourselves a round of applause for being such a good audience. So come on, I know you can do better than that. Let's try again. 1, 2, 3. Give yourselves a round of applause for being such a good audience. I know you guys had it in. You just needed some encouragement. Have a hand for a terrific MC, Conan O'Brien. Hey Conan, how's it going? Haha, great, glad to hear it. So do we have anybody here from that town? Oh, you, sir, where are you from? Ohio. So where do you go for fun when the second Trader Joe's closes? Haha, guys, I'm just getting around. Check out this guy. He's like, whoa, man, too far. Check out this guy in the back. He's like, what? There are two Trader Joe's in Ohio. Haha, guys, I'm just getting around. It's been a great sport. Everybody give it up for Daniel. So some comedians before talking about relationships and or sex, and let me tell you, dating in this modern age just isn't for me, and I know this might come as a surprise to you guys, but yeah, I'm single. I know, don't all gasp at once, like, what, this less intimidating Michael Cera mother can't get a date now, look, guys, I'm not saying I get rejected a lot, but went into a bar yesterday trying to talk to this lady, and she just left, swiped on me, but fellas, you know I'm trying everything, I'm on Tinder, Plenty of Fish, OkCupid, fellas, I'm even on J-Date, and I'm not even J-ish. Okay, anybody here smoke weed? Make some noise if you smoke weed. Haha, I love asking that question, because you know I call people who don't answer it liars. Either that or they're like, oh, wait, what was the question? Haha, oh man, I'm so high right now. Guys, if you're a real stoner, you don't even do 420. It's more like 445. Haha, weed's so sick, though. So, Halloween is right around the corner. Here's the thing I hate about Halloween. That was all that I could fit on my hand. I'm going to be honest with you guys, that didn't really feel natural. Also, there was nothing written on my hand. Thank you guys. I've been Nick Nemiroff.
That is Nick Nemiroff. His appearance on Conan O'Brien passed away not so long ago at the age of 32. Very sad. By all accounts, a really, really sweet guy and very funny. It is Josh Holiday Live. We are on the home stretch. We're winding things down here. But I promise to tell you what the best sex position, according to science, is. When I say they, doctors used an ultrasound scanner to measure blood flow as one test couple had sex in five different positions. Cowgirl, lotus, which is face-to-face and seated, very yoga-like, standard missionary, and missionary with a pillow underneath, and doggy style. This was done at New H Medical, a private gynecology clinic in New York, and is the best sex position for clitoral stimulation and thus orgasm. So of those positions, of those five different positions, if you had to guess, which one do you think gets the lady going the most? Hits that spot, as it were. Scratches that very specific itch in that very specific spot. Well, according to the scans, face-to-face positions tended to be best for clitoral blood flow overall. With, drumroll please, missionary and pillow coming out on top in terms of orgasm potential. Doggy style, meanwhile, came dead last, with researchers noting that, quote, the kneeling rear entry position produces the least amount of direct clitoral contact and resulted in a negligible increase in blood flow compared to the face-to-face positions. So there you go. If you're out there doing your thing, sex, missionary style with a pillow underneath the lady's hips is just the perfect way to make sure that your lover is satisfied. I believe the pillow gets the most amount of contact, as it were. And it's science, people. Science. How could you discount science? Yes. It is Josh Holiday Live. And as I said, we're winding things down here. We were away for a bunch of weeks, not doing live shows, partly because of we can blame Rogers a little bit, because that happened on a Friday and meant our show didn't happen that Friday. And then there was Canada Day, and then I was shooting a film project that happened to be on a Friday. So it's exciting to be back live. I'm excited about it. It is summer. If you want to get in touch with the show, I have mentioned the telephone number where you can call us live during the show, 6476-YO-JOSH. But here's the thing. You can call that number anytime you like, 7 days a week, 365 days a year, 12 months, however you want to quantify all the time, that's when you can call. In terms of what you get when you call there, you can leave a message, a voicemail. We may play it on the show. If you go to Twitter and you want to follow me, it's at Josh Holiday with two L's. On Instagram, it's unfunny. And as a lot of people would say, rings true. If you want old shows or you want more information about this show or anything else, you can go to joshholidaylive.com. It's always fun to be with you, and have yourself an amazing long weekend. And yeah, we'll talk to you soon.
Turn on the lights, open the shades.
The show's over, but the conversation continues. On Twitter at Josh Holiday, on the web at joshholidaylive.com, and hear missed episodes on your favorite podcatcher. Talk that rocks. Josh Holiday Live.
team of professionals, he can help you.
That was vanilla ice cream in the first part of September. I can't wait. I can't wait to see. I don't know how many of the things I'll sample because I have so many food peccadillos. We'll wait. Food in just a bit. Rude in just a bit.
Josh Holiday Live is in your ear. Josh Holiday, and visit joshholidaylive.com. Holidaylive.com.
Oh, there it is. Took a while for that music to start. So that was our flight, and sometimes we're in different rows because I'm a very tall fellow and I.
.com. I'm Jeff Woods and I'm shining a light on music and the rock stars who.
Pretty brilliant comedian who had so much potential, but it ended way too soon. We'll talk about that in just a bit.
Hi, this is a Greg Carrasco.
No radio, no prop.
Pretty brilliant comedian who had so much potential, but it ended way too soon. We'll talk about that in just a bit.
Huh?
Josh Holiday Live. Need to be heard? Tell your phone to call 647-6-YO-JOSH.
Turn on the lights. Open the shades.
The show's over.
Down here, but I promise to tell you what the best sex position according to science is. They